Hi children, how are you? Good morning everyone. How are you all doing? I hope you are doing great. I am also doing good. And have you gone through my earlier video? Yes. What I have told? I have gone through the fourth lesson, meeting Miss Trotwood. I just gave a recap of that lesson. Yeah? I think you all get that lesson. Yeah, if you couldn't get that or if you couldn't understand, see two times, three times or four times, then also if you can't get, you can call me, as my number is scrolling here on the video. You can call me and ask your queries, okay? Without any hesitation you can ask, okay? Now I would like to go through the grammar at a glance. Yeah, up to now we have only completed the four lessons and the classwork of the lessons, like madam told all the meanings, opposites, singular, plural and every other, some of the grammar part. I would like to go through this grammar part so that I can cover the grammar and the lessons too. So all of you, have you all got your books? Have you all? Yes, I think yes. You have to make sure that you have your mulberry book and also grammar tree book with you, because here we have a grammar part and this grammar part is also there in grammar tree book, so we can cover both the books at one time, okay? So this is the reason why I'm asking you to whether you have grammar books or not. If you haven't, take it. Come to the school and take your books quickly, okay? Now let's move into the grammar at a glance. Here in a grammar at a glance we have noun. How many parts of speech are there? Yes, as you are fifth class students, I think you are well aware of parts of speech, right? Eight kinds of parts of speech are there. Repeat after me. What are they? Noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, conjunction, preposition and interjection. Yeah, these were the eight kinds of parts of speech we have been learning from first class to now you are in fifth class. I think you all know what is a noun. What is a noun? Noun is a name of a person or a thing or a place, whatever. If it is a name, that's nothing but a noun. See, I'll give an example. I think you all know my name, no? I'm Blessie. I'm Blessie. Here, what is the noun? Blessie is a noun because my name is Blessie. Yeah? So if it is a name of a person or a thing, like this is a chalk piece is a noun. Or if it is a material or if it is a place, like New Delhi, Hyderabad, Kurnool, like this, whatever name of a places, things, persons, all these come under noun. Yes, in our previous classes we have gone through noun, but in this class we have to particular about what are the types of nouns, okay? Let me go to the types of nouns so that you will clearly understand the nouns and their types, okay? See, open your textbooks and see what I am teaching. See, there are, first one is common noun, common, common noun, and proper noun. Can you see me? P-R-O-P-E-R, proper noun, common noun and proper noun. This is second one. See, what is a common noun and what is a proper noun? Now let's go into the explanation of this. For example, boy, girl, teacher, doctor, Like this, some of names we can say generally in common. We can say generally in common. These nouns are known as common nouns. See, I will say it in a simple manner. If assume that this is your class, this is your fifth class. You have 30 boys and 30 girls. I said to the boys, boys, you're all stand up. If I say to the boys, boys, you're all stand up, means all the boys have to stand up, not one boy. All the 30 boys have to stand up. If I say to girls, girls, keep quiet. Girls, keep quiet. Then girls has to be keep quiet, not only one girl. All the girls has to be keep quiet. This is generalizing. This is known as generalizing. Generalizing all the boys and all the girls. And also teacher is also common noun, because for example, in our school, in our Vishwasai Dr. SRK school, how many teachers are there? About 30. I think about 30 teachers were there. All were known as teachers. All were known as teachers. The teacher is a common noun. Teacher is a common noun. But if you say particularly as an English teacher, that is proper noun. Now I think you get it. Yes? Teacher. All are teachers here. Yes? We all are teachers here who teaches you. But if you say particularly English teacher or a science teacher or a maths teacher, you are specifying the teacher, one teacher out of all the teachers in the school, then that is a proper noun. Okay. If you are saying, imagine that I am saying all the boys sit down, then all the boys will sit down there. If I say Giri, please keep quiet. Giri, please keep quiet. Please keep quiet means this is a proper noun. Why it is a proper noun? Because out of 30 boys in this fifth class, I am pointing out only one boy to be keep quiet. I am not saying to the other boys. I am not giving any command to the other boys. Only I am giving command to one boy. Proper specifying. Specification is nothing but proper noun. Teacher is a common noun. English teacher is a proper noun. And coming to here, doctor. Many doctors were there for us, right? Many doctors were there for each and every organ in our body. For each organ, one doctor is there. Yeah, we generalize all the doctors as who completed MBBS, they were considered as doctors. Who completed the RMP, they were also doctors. And some doctors do their specialization in children, they were known as pediatricians. Who cardiologists means who take care of our heart. Yeah, if there is blocks in heart, they will do surgery for that. Okay, orthopedics. Ortho means joints. So like this, different kinds of doctors were there, but we generally say that I have a visit to doctor, I have an appointment today to go to doctor. So like that, if you say doctor, that is a common noun. That's a common noun. Commonly we are seeing all the doctors in equal manner. But if you specify this doctor as a pediatric doctor, who is pediatric doctor? As you are all kids, if you are not feeling well, if you are sick, your parents will take you to this pediatric doctor. who studies about children and their how to treat them in their illness. They especially they studied about only children, not about eye or nose or mouth. ENT doctors were there who looks after or no who treats for ear, nose and tongue. Like that, for every organ in our body, separate wings and separate department of doctors were there. Okay, now I think you were cleared about common noun and proper noun. Okay, if I am generalizing a boys in the classroom, that is common noun. If I am specifying a name in the class, that is proper noun. If I am generalizing all girls to be keep quiet, that is common noun. If I am pointing out a girl, Sneha, please keep quiet, then that is proper noun, right? In the same way, doctor, teacher, whatever, in a general we say that's come under the common noun. If you are specifying, that is proper noun. Okay, let me go into the next type of noun. So in this common noun, we have two kinds of nouns at. First one is concrete noun, and next one is abstract noun, abstract, concrete, concrete noun and abstract noun. Repeat after me, concrete noun and abstract noun. So first let's go through the concrete noun. So don't misspell that it as a concrete which we use in buildings, that not that concrete ma, not that concrete. Wait, I will explain. Okay, what is meant by the concrete noun? Okay, things which we can see, hear, smell, taste or touch. Things which we can see, I can able to see this book, I can read this as mulberry, yeah, I can touch this, yeah, I can touch this, and I can hold this, I can smell the flavor of, I can smell the fragrance, I can smell the flavor of biryani, dum biryani. It's a concrete noun because which we can see with our eyes, we can hear with our ear, we can smell with our nose, we can taste and touch. You know sense organs, right? What are the sense organs? Say me. In a EVS, I think you have already gone through the sense organs. What are the sense organs? There are five kinds of sense organs we have. Eyes, tongue, nose, ears and skin. These were the five kinds of sense organs. So through these sense organs, if we feel one material, that is a concrete noun. I can feel this book, I can touch this book, I can hold this book. This is a concrete noun. A book is a concrete noun. A chalk piece is a concrete noun. Yeah, a pencil is a concrete noun. If we smell flower, rose, which gets a beautiful fragrance, right? Flower is a concrete noun. Concrete noun means which we can touch with our hands, we can sense or taste it, or we can see it, we can hear it, we can hear whatever we can hear. If you are hearing the songs, that's also come under the concrete noun. Okay, the noun, the things which we can hear, smell, see, taste and touch. This is known as concrete noun. Yeah, mobile, our mobile phone is a concrete one, concrete noun. So we are just talking, we are how we can talk with others by holding like this, hello, how are you? Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, by hearing, you are hearing with your ear. You are hearing with your ear and you are replying to others. So that's also a concrete noun, which we can touch, feel, taste, smell, hear with our sense organs. That is concrete noun. But what is abstract noun? A-B-S-T-R-A-C-T. Abstract noun. That means which we can't see, which we can't see, which we can't touch, which we can't hear. That is abstract noun, which we can't see through our eyes. For example, thirst. Do you know thirst? Do you know thirst? I am a thirsty crow. You have a very good small story in your kindergarten, PP1, PP2, a thirsty crow. What is meant by thirsty crow? Thirst means you have an urge to drink water, right? So thirst means that we can feel it. We can feel. We can't touch the thirst, no? We can't touch or we can't see. We can't see, we can't touch, we can feel. And sad also, we can feel our sadness. If someone scolds us, we can't what is the shape of a sad? Say me, what is the shape of a sad? Don't say like this, emoji, we are all in a world of emojis, right? We just send a emoji in a WhatsApp rather than to type something. Yeah? Not this emoji. We can't see sadness. We can't see. What is the shape of a sadness? Is it triangle, rectangle or circle? There is no shape. What is the shape of a joy? What is the shape of a joy? Happiness. There is no shape. So the things which we can't see, which we can't see, only we can feel. Only we can feel, the which we can't see, which we can't touch, which we can't hear. Those are known as abstract nouns, which we can feel, touch, hear, smell. These nouns are known as concrete nouns. These were quite opposite. Here we can feel and he can hear and touch. This abstract noun we can't feel. We just feel, but we can't touch. We can't touch, we can't hear. So they were the abstract noun which we can't see through our eyes. Which we can't see through our eyes. That is abstract noun. Let me go to the other one. Yeah, see. Next one is material noun. Fifth one, material noun. Material noun means, M-A-T-E-R-I-A-L. Material noun means the noun which got from other sources. The noun which we got from other sources. For example, from cotton. From cotton, we'll get cotton dresses. Right? We'll get cotton dresses. From cotton, we'll get cotton dresses. From wool of a sheep. Do you know that rhyme at your kindergarten time? Baba, black sheep, have you any wool? Yes, sir, 3 bags full. Yes? Wool of a sheep, which we can use to make sweaters. Which we can use to make sweaters. In winter season, we use sweaters in winter season to keep us very cozy and warm. Yeah, and from bamboo, we can get the papers. We can get the papers. So like this, from teak wood, we can get our chairs, our doors, our windows. So whatever we can. So the material that we get from the sources, the material, the noun that we get from the sources is known as material noun. Understood? Things used to make other things. One thing is used to make other things. Here one thing is used to make other things. Do you know DIYs? DIYs means there were a lot of wastage that we can see in our houses. But someone, they recycle that wastage material and they used in different kinds. For example, I will say my experience. So I have a small boy who is 5 years old. He is in PP2. So he loves ketchup. He loves tomato ketchup. Yeah, after completion of the tomato ketchup, I don't throw that bottle. I don't just throw out that bottle. I paint that bottle. I used to paint that bottle very creatively with some like a stickers like Doraemon and Motu Patlu, like that stickers or some leaves and flowers I draw, and I use that bottle as a flower vase. See how we are using one material to the other. That ketchup bottle is used, I used that ketchup bottle as a flower vase. So that one thing that come from the other thing is nothing but a concrete noun, material noun. Material, one thing that was made from other thing. One thing that was made from other thing, that is a material noun. Yeah. Now here, now getting to the last one, noun number. I think you all got my point, right? First one, what is the first one? Common noun, proper noun. Common noun, proper noun. Commonly we said boys, girls, and properly specifying the boy and the girl or a teacher or a doctor. That's it. And next, a concrete noun, which we can feel, which we can touch, which we can smell, which we can hear. That is a concrete noun. Which we can't see, which we can't touch, which we can't see, which we can't hold. They were known as abstract, like joy, happiness, sad, thirsty, like that. These were all the feelings that we can't see. Yeah. And last one, material noun. From one thing, if we can get one thing from the other thing, resource, that is known as a material noun. Here we have noun number. First one is countable noun. So up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is sixth one, countable noun. What is this countable noun? Countable noun means, I will say you an example. See here, in my arm I have some chalk pieces. I can count these chalk pieces, 1, 2, and 3. Yes, here chalk pieces are countable. We can count these chalk pieces. Chalk piece which we can count, that is known as countable noun. We can count chalk piece. We can count how many desks are there in our school. We can count how many benches are there in our school. We can count how many slides and how many seesaws were there in our school. That is known as countable noun. If we can't count uncountable, uncountable. What is uncountable? What is uncountable? Countable means which we can count as 1, 2. Yeah, I have 5 pencils. Pencils, we can count this. Yeah, pencil, we can count. Chalk, we can count this. I have 3 chalk pieces. Yeah, like this. So persons, bench. In my class, I have 30 benches, like that. And I have three sisters. These are all persons or things which we can count. Which we can count is known as countable nouns. But what is uncountable? That means we can't count. we can't count in a number. For example, can you count how many drops of water are there in your bottle? Can you count how many drops of water are there in your bottle? No. These kinds are known as uncountable. Can you count water drops? No. See, this is my hair. Can you count my hair? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many? Up to how much you can count? This is uncountable. Yeah? Hair, we can't count this. Yes? Sand, if you take an armful of sand, can you count that? How many small pellets of sands are there? Can you count that? No, we can't count. And stars in the sky, we can see many stars in the sky. Sometimes we can see one or two, sometimes we can see more than 100. We can't count. We'll get confused to count one after one. So these uncountable words are known as they come under uncountable, which we can count in quantity, which we can count in number is known as countable, which we can't measure, they were known as uncountable nouns. You do one thing, go to your kitchen and take that sugar. Do you know sugar, which you will add in your milk or tea or coffee? You go on, can you count the sugar pellets? How many sugar pellets will become a half kg of sugar? How many sugar pellets will become a half kg of sugar? Shall we count? Is it possible? No. We have too much of patience we have. It is uncountable. So that kind of nouns are known as, they come under uncountable nouns. Okay. In this category, here we have one more. Singular nouns, plural nouns. Plural nouns, collective noun. Singular, plural and collective. If only one thing is there, that is singular noun. If there is only one thing, like one ant, one apple, one ball, one carrot, one dog, that is singular noun. If there are one or more, 3 dogs, 5 dogs, 6 carrots, 7 balloons, which we can count. That is a singular noun. This is countable. This come under countable, but this is only one. You know one and many concept, right? You have gone through this concept in your first class only. Only one thing is here. It might be a girl, one girl, one boy, one bat, one ball, like this. More than one. 5 balls, 6 balls, 7 balls, like 10 cake pieces, like this. These were the plural nouns. And what is meant by the collective nouns? Collective nouns means, so you have to concentrate on this collective noun. Collective noun means, if we have a collection of a same thing, what we will say that? Do you like mangoes? Yeah, I think you all like mangoes. If there are many mangoes which our mother placed in a bucket. There are many mangoes which our mother placed in a bucket. Then we will say that a bucket full of mangoes. Where do I have to write? Collective noun examples. A bucket full of mangoes. See the difference here. In a singular noun, only one thing, one mango, one apple, one boy, one girl, that's it. In plural, more than one. Two boys, two girls. Three boys, three girls, three mangoes. But here collective means if there are so many which belong to one category. There are many mangoes that our mother filled it in a basket means basket full of mangoes. How we ask water which your mother or someone else, how you ask water? Can you give me 2 drops of water? Is it correct? Can you give me 3 drops of water? 3 drops of water is enough for me. Please give me. That's not right. We have to ask like a glass of water. Give me a glass of water. Yeah? A glass of water. A cup of tea. A cup of tea. You can't ask, give me 2 drops of tea. It's enough. Is it correct? It's very awkward. We can't ask 3 drops, 4 drops, 5 drops of tea. We have to ask, give me a cup of tea. So like this, if any noun that is more in number, if any noun that is more in number, we have to tell it collectively. So what is this diagram? What is this diagram? These are birds. Yes, we can see many birds that way flying in the sky. So how can we say these birds? Many birds were flying in the sky. That's also right. But we call these birds collectively known as a flock of birds. What is that? A flock. It is not frog, ma. It is not frog. It is flock. F-L-O-C-K. Flock of birds. You have to say flock of birds. A flock of birds were flying over the sky. A flock of birds were flying over the sky. If there are many sheep were there. Sheep. That is known as a herd of sheep. Herd of sheep. Herd of sheep. H-E-R-D. Herd of sheep. Like this, if a noun, it has more in number, so that we can tell this in a collective manner. Collective manner. If you have, do you know how you purchase apples, not apples, grapes. How you purchase grapes? A bunch. Do you know? A bunch of apples, a bunch of grapes you can purchase. Not one grape, two grape, three grapes. What we can say that? A bunch of grapes. That is collective noun. We are saying that noun that is grapes as bunch of grapes. If you have different kinds of keys with you, you have to say, I have a bunch of keys with me. These are known as collective. Collectively we are saying one thing. Collectively we are saying one thing. Okay? Now I think you all get to know about the types of nouns. Types of nouns. How many types of nouns are there? Common noun, proper noun. Common means common, proper means specifying. Countable, uncountable, not that. Concrete noun. Concrete noun means which we can touch, smell, hear, taste and everything. Abstract means which we can't see. Happiness, joy, patience. Can we see patience? We can't see. Yeah? Sadness, thirsty, that were all abstract which we can't see. And next, coming to countable and uncountable. Countable means the noun which we can count in number. Uncountable means which we can't count, like our hair, stars, sand, like this. And coming to this countable nouns only, singular noun means only one apple, one ant, one ball, like that. Plural means more than one, 2 balls, 3 balls, like that. And collective means collective of one noun. like collective of sheep known as herd of sheep. Collection of many birds are known as flock of birds. Bunch of grapes, bunch of keys, a flower bouquet, a bunch of flowers, like that we have to say. So this is your class. If you want to write notes, just take notes to your write down notes in your classroom by taking a screenshot. Then only you can get this right. Examples as how I have written here. Okay, that's for your class today. And in the next class, we'll go through another part of the grammar. Thank you. I hope you all get my class and give your feedback whether it is slow or fast, whether you get me or not. Give me your feedback whether it is whatever it is, positive or negative. Okay, thank you. Have a good day. Have a nice day. Bye. Take care.